If being crowned the winner in a season of all winners and earning $1 million in the process is not enough to inspire you, how about $2 million?
$2 million, not too shabby. That's a sneak peek at Wednesday's premiere of Survivor Winners at War, the landmark 40th season celebrating 20 years of Survivor, where 20 winners battle it out. I've actually played Survivor 3 times, as Jeremy knows.
Yeah, I've heard.
Never talk about it. No, I did. Season 22, 26, and 34. So it was so great to reconnect with the show's host, Jeff Probst, about this season and more. Take a look. Jeff, thank you so much for being
here. It's so bizarre now that you are no longer the survivor, Andrea.
Yeah.
You're now people's Andrea. This has become a gig.
Put you in the hot seat here.
I'm ready.
But we were just talking about, you said you think this is the best season.
Yes, I really do. And I'm not hyping it. I think fans are going to say it's going to be tough to beat that season. 20 winners, $2 million, edge of extinction, bragging rights. It's just this combustible recipe.
And so many huge personalities. Who do you think of the 20 winners has the biggest target on their back?
That's a great question, and it probably depends who you're asking, but I would say because Rob and Amber are there together, you have to look at those two and say, we got to take one. If I was Rob and Amber, I think one of us has got to be the first one out. They're going to get rid of one of us. But you know Rob. I mean, he always finds a way to say, let me just propose another idea to you.
Oh, I know Rob. He won my first season.
Yes.
And tricked us all. A lot of people in the premiere press were gunning for Sarah, which gave me validation because she won my 3rd season. And she's very dangerous, too.
Oh, Sarah's amazing. And Sarah says early on, I'm coming to win this game with an intensity that did even I went, wow, you've got another level. But there are no easy players. Mm-hmm. You know, it's very hard to win this game. You've yet to do it, and you're a very good player.
3-time loser right
here.
Yeah.
One way to look at it.
But it's really difficult. If you were playing, who would you target first, and who would you align with?
I would probably target Yule, maybe Tony, Sarah. I would align with Rob.
Okay.
That guy has the ability to get out of more situations. I know he's going to get me sooner or later, but I just like the way he plays.
Yeah.
Or Parvati. If I could get Rob and Parvati together, that'd be a pretty good team.
Now, obviously, it's only winners eligible to play this season, but I had to ask Jeff, is there someone out there who didn't win Survivor that he would love to see play with this group?
Lots of people. I mean, right off the bat, I think of somebody like Devins, who I'd love to see come back. And I was sort of implying this with you earlier. When we meet people to be on the show, I always say, just remember, it doesn't matter where you're voted off in terms of us wanting you to play again. It means nothing to us. Are you a player? Because great players get voted out early all the time. So it really, and people get to the end that you go, we'd never have you back. It just wasn't enough there. That's why you've played 3 times. We know you are a player. You just have to have the right chemistry to pull off the win.
It's hard to win because if people see you as a target or you're good at challenges, that's a negative.
Yep.
And so you have this target on your back.
Maybe we'll address that in the future. We're gonna slowly start to evolve to the next layer, which is where's the penalty for getting rid of somebody? We got to get back into that a little bit.
Okay. Do you see this show going on just forever, kind of SNL style, if you had your choice?
Well, I mean, if we knew it could. But we really only look at it one season, not even 1 year, because we do 2 in a year. We look at it as 1 season, and we just focus on that season. And then we start going, okay, 42. And then if it works, then CBS says, why don't you go do 43 and 44? So I've been doing this for 20 years, and I have never, ever thought, oh, we'll for sure be on 3 years from now.
Yeah.
Because you don't know when the bottom's going to fall out. It's not going to fall out this season.
When you first got this job, honestly, how many seasons did you think it would go?
This is what I thought, because I was pretty new to TV, so I knew nothing. The first season was watched by 72 million people, the finale. So I knew we'd get a second season. The second season premiered after the Super Bowl, 45 million people. So I knew we'd get a 3rd season, but I knew the 3rd season would be the end. So Africa, we were shooting, and I thought, well, this is cool. I'm in Kenya. I got 3 seasons of this cool show.
Yeah.
And that was 19 years ago.
Wow. So you never know.
Never know.
Do you remember where you were just kind of mentally and in your career when you got this job?
Oh, yeah.
were you at a place where like things were going well, or like this kind of changed everything for you?
Changed everything. I had $8,000 in the bank. I had said no to a bunch of shows for, I hadn't worked in 18 months. I was doing Rock and Roll Jeopardy on VH1, but it didn't pay much. And I just kept waiting. I was looking for something I could sink my teeth into, and I was getting offered jobs, but they were prompter-based dating shows where I just felt like that's just not gonna satisfy me. And then I heard Mark Burnett on the radio. I was driving on the 405 in Los Angeles, and he talked about this idea. I'm gonna abandon 16 people and force them to live together and then vote each other out. It's called Survivor. That's all I heard. I was like, oh my God, what is that? And I'm telling you, Andrea, never in my life have I gone after something spiritually, trying to market my way in. Everything in my mind was, I've got to get Survivor. That is going to be a super cool show.
Yeah, and here you are, season 40.
I know.
It's, yeah, it turned out to be the right decision.
Oh, yeah.
Survivor has so many celeb fans as well. Naturally leads people to ask about celebrity seasons of the competition. Jeff told you, Andrea, about some of the show's most famous fans and whether he thinks a special celeb season could ever be possible.
Well, Marvelous Miss Maisel just learned.
Rachel Brosnahan,
yes.
Huge fan.
Yes,
I interviewed her backstage at the SAG Awards, and she came up to me. She's like, I'm not stalking you, but I'm watching your second season, and you're doing really well. Like, it's so great.
Somebody like she would be great. Fallon's a fan. Neil Patrick is a fan. Dominic Monaghan.
Tyler Perry.
Because
he has something to do with the Tyler Perry Idol,
the
right?
Super Idol.
Okay.
Yes. And it's really fun when people like Tyler and Fallon does it a lot, send me notes with ideas. Because I'm still this kid from Wichita going, pretty sure this is Jimmy Fallon with an idea for a show I work on. We gotta make this happen. But in terms of doing a celebrity season, the truth is when I've approached people a few years ago, everybody goes, look, honestly, I could barely get 8 days off, let alone 39.
Yeah.
So if you ever did it, it would have to be a really short, maybe Christmas special where you go to Hawaii for 8 days, and then is it Survivor?
Not really.
No.